There you go.
That's it. Yeah. Ooh, we got stuff.
All right, what's up, Locker Nuts? Look at the cold January Friday we got right now. I don't care. I'm still very happy because we got some stuff to dig through. All right, so I got the van that we loaded yesterday. Not loaded, like full, but loaded a bunch of stuff in here. Stopped at my storage locker and grabbed some more empty bins, some table, and some garbage cans. It's what I refer to as the tools of the trade. So I've got these garbage bags that I grabbed out of the locker, this box, that, a couple boxes, the black and yellow totes we already went through, and that's the good stuff. We got five boxes or five totes to go into our live auctions of good stuff that we already found in this locker. A couple suitcases right there. These two biggies right here. That's enough stuff to have some fun and hopefully find some treasures. Let's find out, guys. We're gonna do it right now. This is the locker that I paid $810 through an online auction. This is a 10% fee. So 891 bucks. This is called 900 bucks. It's right next to the Oakland Coliseum. If you didn't watch the last video, go back and watch it. Come on, go back and watch it. All right, let's get into it. All right. Okay, let's see what we got. Ooh, this is an interesting looking box. Okay, I got some VHS. Here, looks like you tape some programs. I don't care too much about that. This though, look at this. More Kiss stuff, a pillow, 1986. That's kind of neat. That is kind of neat. Ah, these are nasty, dirty, but that's kind of cool. Kiss, and what is that? Is that, I think it's to go over your head, around your neck, or whatever. Definitely looks older. Condition's not great here, but Kiss. We found so much Kiss stuff already. Same thing right there, but that one's with the Punisher. It's yellowed out. We'll let that go to the market. I got a little bin already started right there for Stockton. What does this say? Todd, 2006. Yeah. Alright. Some kind of little light up thing for Halloween. We'll let that go to the market. It's the plastic. That will probably sell pretty quick. We like the morbid stuff out there. All right, what's this? Trading cards. Topps trading cards inside. Collect all 12. What is this? It's a box from something. I don't think those have any value. We'll let the market decide that. Okay, a couple more pennants. Found some already. San Francisco Giants. No date. 49ers, that'll sell right now. 49ers doing very, very well at the moment. I don't know when the video is going to come out. Tomorrow they play again, so they could be out tomorrow. And then the Sharks, these are all Bay Area teams for us. Good stuff. That's all sellable merch. Now the Giants here. Looks newer. Year 2000, I think. Ah, this is good. Couple flags here. 49ers and Giants. And then these guys are put in your window of your car. Yeah, I see a 49er right there. I might have to pull that one out. That's kind of cool. Oh, here is Michael Myers. Oh, he's a little twisted up. Okay, can we reveal his real face? I don't think the mask comes off. But we found the box for this, and I was hoping we'd find him. Show enough. But we gotta find his arm. There it is. All right, now we got his arm. Next step is we've got to find his knife. Say hey 3000, Willie Mays. That's cool. Why is that taped on there? Little Grim Reaper. It's kind of cool, but the glass is broken. I think I'm gonna let that go. Coors Light mirror. That's pretty good. I don't know. Beer stuff seems to be hit or miss for me lately. Some of it we sell really well and some of it we do not sell well. But something like that I'll bring to a better flea market. We'll try it there first. Ooh, oh man. It looks like it's got water damage, but there's a signature right there and it's George Wilburn or something like that. Is that one of the actors that played Michael Myers? That is pretty cool. Anything signed. This guy really is into the horror stuff and the death metal stuff. Knife. Hein. Okay. Jeez. Oh, look at this, you guys. This locker, if you didn't watch our plumber collector series, this is years ago. I think before COVID, I found fantastic lockers. It was owned by a guy that was a plumber. He had a lot of this like very hard rock. He had wrestling stuff. He had horror stuff. Here's another signed piece. I think that's probably Undertaker. Just because he had so much Undertaker. This one is also signed. And there right here. Undertaker. I'll let the frame go though. Will Clark signed. That's awesome, guys. This is really good stuff. This is the kind of stuff we like to put in our live auction because it's just fun. It's fun stuff. Will Clark, a little plaque thing. Fear the Reaper, I think that might be a group. And then Undertaker. We found some of these already too, these little glass displays. Found a bunch of them. He did not store his pennants very well. But there's the San Francisco 49ers right there, 1996. A's, Giants, 2002. Not too impressed with this stuff. Maybe we can figure out how to flatten it out. I'm sure it can be pressed out. San Francisco. Couple umbrellas. Oh, this right here. Oh, yeah. Wait, there's this. Okay. It's a license plate. Clock. That's neat. That's going to be a fun auction piece. And then right here is Michael's knife. Oh, I almost cut myself. Just kidding. Coors Light shaped like a football. I mean, with the football pattern. Bass. I don't know about this stuff, guys. I'll take it to Stockton. Coors shaped like a bat. And whatever that is. Ah, come on. That's going to recycle. Give me a break. San Francisco Giants. That's cool. Luggage tag. Okay, that's a good first box right here. You know, I just had to look this up just to see, and it turns out this is a Willie Mays 500 home run club. And they do sell for some money. $17.50 on this one right here, plus $10 shipping. That one seems a little high. Here's a set right here, which it looks like it's got that one and two others for only $9. There's two for $12, so I'm not sure why the variance in the price. Here's that one. No, this one, $5.50. $12. Not talking about big money, but there is a little bit of collectability to those for sure. So we'll take it to the market. Yeah. All right, let's see what's in the garbage bag. World's best mom. Baby clothes. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, it's turning bad real quick. Baby clothes. What's this? Betsy Johnson. They're pretty thrashed. Pretty thrashed. I'll let that go to market. Baby clothes, or even, you know, little kid clothes, doesn't sell so well at the market. I mean, it does sell, but not for big money. And even when we have vintage kids clothes, we take it to the vintage market. We don't get that much for it. It's not very popular. I love athletics baseball. A's, I might put that aside. Go to the better market. It's a women's shirt. Santa Cruz, it's okay. I'll tell you what, guys, clothes is one of the best things that we've got going when we go to the better flea markets. You got to pull out the better stuff. You know, you got to pull out the vintage and the sport. You know, just like I said in the last video, the sports stuff, the vintage stuff. I mean, especially, look at that. Especially the vintage stuff. It is sometimes the majority of what we sell. Okay, there's some weird stuff in here. Yeah, maybe we'll go through the rest of this off camera, but used to be we'd overlook clothes and just be like, donate or go to the market, dollar each. But if you take your time and you start learning the brands and learning, you know, what to look for, you can make, there's a lot of money in clothes right now. All right, guys, a lot of clothes. A couple weird things. We're just going to leave those out of the context here. I did find a couple of scarves here. Feels like silk, and that's kind of nice. I don't know this brand, but Oh yeah, Victoria Trading Company. So it's got a nice M right there. There's this right here, which is a nice scarf. Beautiful. Got some lions on it. Says it's Scotta. It's Scotta. I think that's a good brand. I don't really know. I'll show it to Gianna. She'll decide. Maybe we'll auction it. And then I found this Capri. It's like it's a big stain right there. Never mind. We'll let that go. There's stains on this too. This is a Victoria's Secret VSX Sport, like yoga pants. Those are good sellers, but it's stained up. And then that one that we found before. All right, so we did not find very much stuff, unfortunately. All right, let's grab another bag here. Okay, this is, I thought it was scarves. It's definitely lady stuff, right? It's not guy stuff. And this is kind of nice. It's a dress, right? It's not bad. No tags though, no tags. What am I gonna do about that? This is cool right here. That's dirty though. Jeez. Rayon, made in Indonesia. It's got that tie-dye look. It's very cool. Nice big scarf or body wrap or something, or what's the, it's probably a word for it. Already I'm looking at this going, I think this is one for Gianna right here. I think Gianna needs to go through this one. Maybe she'll be back at some point and can help out. I'm gonna save that for her, I think, because I don't know what to do with that stuff. All right, put that back. Okay, this guy I know has some interesting stuff in here. It's a hamper with the handles busted out. Empty box right here for some kind of kit, race car kit. More electronics there, packaging. But look at this, guys, right here. Poker player, Alexander DaCosta. It's got a little chip in there, like a poker chip. Some nice perfumes. This right here is Ralph Lauren. We just sold a bottle just like that the other night in our auction. This one's less full than the other one we had, I think was half full. This one's pretty good. Fragrances sell well for us, so that's a good find. All right, got a little bathroom stuff here, Lysol. Nose hair trimmer, I'm gonna assume. Empty Q-tips, lots of shavers and stuff. Yeah, nothing too interesting in there. That's good for the market. The leather bag's pretty nice though. I was hoping maybe they took a ring off or something. Took the bracelet off, put it in there. Found a little gold. I think that's leather right there. That ain't bad. That's empty. Why even store that? This is good. Schick Hydro 3. It's a little crushed up and a little dirty, but razors are stinking expensive right now. Like everything else, thanks to our politicians for messing that up. This, I think, some more fragrance. Yeah. Yeah, this smells good. It's pretty good. I don't know what the brand is. I'll have to Google lens it or something. Figure it out. All right, nice thing about being at home when I go through stuff, I can just grab bins. I got all my supplies and everything in here. Makes it very, very convenient. So check this out, guys. Just kind of like with the electronics, he had so many brand new electronics here. He's got tons of brand new razors. It's kind of bizarre. LG Blu-ray disc player. I think we found a remote for that already. Now I found another one. Yeah. Okay, let that go. Oh, man, more 007. What's that? Shower gel. It's got some of his deodorant on there though, but James Bond 007, this is different. I can wipe it off with the dirty clothes that I found. Okay, what's this? Oh, this is a diamond tester. Not a very good one, but it does. I mean, I can almost say it does the job, but I haven't had a whole bunch of luck with those. Needs new batteries though, but I'll put it aside. I have a much better gem tester. More of these. Good. Oh, it's empty. Kiss him. It's cologne. Kiss brand cologne. Funny. Let's see if we find it. Angry Birds toothbrushes. This is a walkie-talkie. Beofang. Put that aside. I'm going to put these aside. We'll probably just give those away. Not a lot of value, just a little bit of fun. There's another 007 right here. And there's a cracked up Motorola. Really bad shape. Rubber ducky, and he's very sticky. CVS. I'll put those in the market. GVC. Another Kiss fragrance. What the heck is this? How weird. This is for a bike right here. Strap it on. Little brake light. Jeez, so many remotes. Midland public alert. Here's a little Android phone. Oh boy, that's brand new in there. Arcos. And there's a Nokia tablet right here. This is decent stuff. It's really surprising sometimes what you find in these storage lockers. Okay, it is used, but I don't see any cracks or anything, so that's okay. My charge, a little battery backup, or power bank, whatever. This is for that walkie-talkie. Interesting. It's a little drone right there. I'm going to let that go. Kind of a chart. What is that? I don't know. Sharper image. Some sort of remote right here. That's for Chrome. Google Chrome or something. Charger. Doubt that's anything. A couple transformers. There's an antenna for something. More razors. That's more money. And this is more money. Samsung tablet right here. Model SM-T350. That's another Samsung right there. Dang. Finding a lot of tablets in here. Pain pen. Stun gun. Ooh, that sounds like fun. What do we got here? Oh. Holy crap, that works. Okay, I normally would say, I'm gonna try that on myself. But not today, guys. Not when I've had a heart attack recently. Probably not the best thing to do. Probably. There's a nice wallet. Pretend and play. Okay. A ton of chargers. Got our cables, you know. Nokia phone right here. Oh, that's a nice little phone. Put this in an electronic slot, probably. Oh, look at this. 9-inch tablet. I don't know the brand here, but it definitely looks like a decent box. That's it. Okay, good. Boy, I hope it doesn't start raining on me. Feels like it's gonna start. Razer Mach 3. Look at this. More tablets. That's a Motorola. Funny. This is an Amazon. That's cool. It's a Kindle. It's working. Just needs to be charged. Yeah, some little containers. Okay, a couple little VTech Super Sports right here. Don't know. Okay. Ooh, that's a nice phone right here. Eh, maybe not. Huawei? Sounds like it's a Chinese company. There's something for the sharper image. I think that was a cradle for that remote right there. Okay, another... Jeez, I don't know what it is. It works. That goes there. And message reminder.
At South Shore here in Alameda, Walgreens, Quest Diagnostics, and Jada Recycling. Thanks.
What?
At South Shore.
How do we skip to the next one? It says 8. So did he just like record messages for himself? Oh, that's cool. USB charging station. All right, Jana's back at home, so she's going to help with the women's clothes.
Women's clothing. This looks like the lingerie department.
Oh, it does? That's nightwear?
Yeah, I think so. Yep, California Dynasty. That is lingerie.
Is it good or is it just...
It's actually a decent brand.
So yeah. Should we go to better flea market with that? Or?
Yeah, that's kind of it. Let's see what's in the bag before I make that call.
Okay, this is the one I got stumped on. And I was like, I don't think I'm qualified for this.
It's a dress, a halter dress.
Uh-huh. I didn't see any labels. But it's, what is it, rayon or silk?
It's like a scarf dress.
Yeah.
There should be a tag. Right here. Polyester.
Okay. Large, extra large.
Mm-hmm. And then here's the robe that goes to that.
Okay.
Floral piece. California Dynasty. All right. So this is a Sabrina by Mervyn's. That's interesting.
Yeah. Is that vintage?
It might be.
Mervyn's. Wait, what is this? Is this silk?
Yeah, I don't know.
Polyester, dang it.
So I'm feeling like this is for lingerie department. I'm feeling a lot of 80s to 90s Mervyn's. Oh, something on here.
No tag on that one.
Spanx.
Some of this stuff is money, though.
Higher power Spanx, $34. Still sealed.
Okay. Put that aside, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because we could sell that maybe in the auction.
Yeah.
Brand new, so.
Yeah. M.T. Morgan Taylor, medium
Intimates.
Large.
Medium large. The other one's... Large, extra large.
Yeah. So another camisole. Another nighttime wear. Someone likes to feel pretty. Morgan Taylor.
Good, right?
It's okay, yeah. It's Mervyn's Macy's, I think. Mm. So, but I definitely think it is like kind of 90s.
Okay. Yeah.
Camisole.
I mean, they must have had a big closet. Have that she much liked, nightwear.
She liked her nightwear. And then a robe.
Apartment 9. That's
Walmart maybe or something. Rayon tie-dye.
Oh yeah, I pulled this out and looked
sarong.
At it. I saw a little stain on it, but it's pretty
cover
cool.
Up.
That's definitely Danza. This is, I think it's worth watching. Washing.
Rayon.
Is that good?
Yeah, they're sarongs.
Sarong.
Or like a cover up. You tie them up. Remember, I had those when we went to Hawaii.
I meant good for selling. So, is this auction stuff? Because we need to make a separate pile.
No, I think the flea market's a good.
Okay.
You want to put them all there?
If they're going to Danza.
And then this is another mango reef made in India.
Okay. 100% cotton, though.
Yeah. Here's another sarong.
More sarong? You can't go wrong with a sarong.
Givenchy.
Stockings?
Yeah, this is vintage for sure. Size D, blue. That's kind of interesting.
All right. Put that aside.
Givenchy is a good brand.
Yeah.
Reflections, image of you.
That's right. I saw this too. I don't see a price.
It's a 90. She really had a very expansive nightwear collection.
Yeah, what's that? That's...
Sabrina by Mervyn's. This is the same as the blue, but in red. That neckline is, it's like a
it's
pirate
Victorian
shirt.
Victorian almost, yeah.
It it's is, like a pirate blouse, yeah.
It's like Victorian.
And just a little tank. And then a sheer little cover up. Okay. For a bathing suit.
Maybe we're going to pause this now, guys, because this is, like, not that exciting. But we'll review any really exciting stuff that we find. It's good stuff, but we have a safe to open later, so the excitement's going to stick around. It's going to get a lot more exciting.
It's getting hot in here.
Oh, there's a little piece of cedar in there. That's good.
Yeah, I saw that.
So pride and ownership, you
that's
know?
That's for sure.
All right, guys, went through that whole bag. Mostly all women's underwear,
Chinese,
right?
Bras.
Yeah.
And nightwear.
Yeah, but nicer stuff. Okay,
some
right?
Of it, yeah.
This right here, we put all the brand new tights in this box here. And, I mean, they're all considered tights, right? Stock hosiery, whatever. We'll probably just sell all this as one big lot on our auction. Just put all together. This is the more interesting stuff right here.
Hello Kitty and Michael Jackson money.
That's never found that before. There's a locker nuts first right there.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll sell that in the auction or give it away or something.
I'm not sure why she has like these tags in here.
I think it's garbage.
Yeah,
it's tags off of like clothes or toys, and then they put them in these top loaders for like baseball cards.
And was there anything in here?
They're little plugs.
Oh.
Christian Louboutin bag. There's these little plugs that maybe go on the shoes somehow.
Yeah, it's for the bottom of the heel.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah, yeah. For like a high heel.
Mm-hmm.
And then
tagged underwear.
Victoria's Secret.
Spanx, another brand. And then all these are new tagged underwear, which we've done really well in the past.
Yeah, if you guys go to our eBay store, you'll see we have a lot of Victoria's Secret, but most of it's vintage. Some of this might be vintage.
Yeah, we don't know.
But often we're able to sell... takes a while, they don't sell overnight, but this is something different, that brand. But the Victoria's Secret, we're able to sell it for more.
Well, this is a matching set too, so it's kind of nicer.
That one's used though, right?
I don't know, it looks very clean, but I don't know. No tags.
Victoria's Secret, size large. Right, but when we find stuff with tags on it, we're often able to sell it for more than the tagged price.
100%.
On eBay. So, yeah, like this right here, $12.50, but who knows, this might be discontinued, and sometimes we can sell it for $30.
Yeah, some people really love certain styles of underwear, so they get really attached to them, so when they find them on eBay, they'll buy them.
Yeah, so. They want that same one, so when they wear it out, they go back.
I get it.
The same thing. Me too. Yeah. Okay, looks like some women's clothes, but maybe some more dressier stuff.
All right, this is like a shirt, Spencer Jeremy.
Is that women's?
Yeah.
Okay. Wait, this is silk.
Yeah.
100% silk right here. Let's put that aside.
Rena Rowan silk.
Oh, yeah, and we found all these sarongs right here, so I think we showed those on video.
And then pants. Sweatpants.
Okay.
Now, if we can find some athletic wear, we'll be really happy.
It does okay at the market.
80s baseball lifestyle. This is 2016, though, not that old.
So, you go sling it to the Stockton, it's a dollar or two.
If that. This isn't, yeah. Oh.
What is that?
These are legging jeans.
They're jeggings, right? Is that what you call
it? That's not even a jegging. No. This is now.
Jeggings are like real denim.
Yeah.
That is actually pretty funny.
That's something.
Jeannie slim jeggings. It's jeggings. See right there?
Blouse. Couple shirts.
So we have a lot of these garbage bags in the locker. Don't know if they're all clothes. I know some of them aren't.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them are other things.
So women's casual wear in this one so far.
She bought a lot of clothes though.
Yeah, I think you should be pretty thankful for me right now. I realize how lucky I am. Pants.
You have two closets.
Two small ones. Molly and Maxie. Whoa. Glitter
those
alert.
Are fancy.
Concept.
What's this though? Molly and Maxie, that's in Guatemala, is it nothing? Sag Harbor.
Mm-hmm. She had some stuff from India, I noticed. A tapestry. This says made in Italy.
Oh.
So that's kind of cool. Let's look at that.
Yeah, let's put that aside.
That's neat.
Yeah. I mean, I would have called it a placemat, but it says tapestry.
Look how good I am.
Tapestry,
some
placemat.
Pantalones.
Oh, these are jazzy too.
More
leather action on it.
So a lot of pants. So this is a lot of Target wear. Don't knock Target, you know.
Yeah. It
has quality clothing. Some sort of gadgetry.
Yeah, it's a part to something.
A lot of pants. Okay, what do we got in here? A What is this?
That's electronics. You remember I told you I found a lot of electronics already.
What's that?
That's some kind of underwater camera right there.
That's kind of cool. In the middle of a globing bag.
Yeah, it's random.
Yeah, I've never seen that.
Yeah, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah.
More clothing.
A little better.
More clothing. Oh, wait, I think I see a tag. Oh, little baby baseball bats.
This is on sale for $31.
Look how cute.
That's Calvin Klein, Jenna. Yeah. Here, let's pull this out, Calvin
Klein. Hey, batter, batter, batter. Swing.
Okay.
That's so cute. It's
gonna be little balls you're hitting there.
That's so cute.
Hey, can we return this? You got a return tag on it? No.
Some postcards, a personal
Calvin
photo.
Klein brand new. I'm gonna take that aside. I'll bring that to the better flea market. Wait, this Vera bats? Wing. Wait, that's Vera Wing.
A hanger is. Oh, a little kid clothes now.
Oh boy. Daddy sidekick. Yeah. That's what it's looking like now, huh?
Yeah, it's all baby boy clothes. Oh,
yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. Aw, baby boy clothes. We haven't had baby boy clothes in so long because we've had only baby granddaughters.
What? What you saying?
No baby boys.
Okay.
I'm the next big thing. That's funny. What's this? This is interesting. Todd 1. Huh. Oh, that's kind of interesting. I wonder if that has any value.
Mm.
Looks older. Okay. Oh, wait. I got something in here.
Yeah.
Bra straps. Sweet.
All right. We'll dig through the bottom
another
and see
bat.
The same thing. Jenna loves the little bats.
They're so cute.
Okay. Next bag. It's looking like men's clothes this time. Oh, we got them on hangers, though. So.
Is that good or bad?
If I bring a clothes rack, it's good. Because even in Stockton, we get a little bit more money.
Mark Anthony.
How funny. G. Farrar. Claiborne. Sonoma.
Walmart.
Wrangler. Denim shirt. Mm-hmm. Is that better? No? Okay. St. John's Bay?
Walmart.
Is it? Oh, funny. Axis. Axis.
Axis is I think Macy's old brand.
I like this one.
It's super slim fit.
I'm not saying for wearing it. I just like the color.
Yeah. Those things don't sell like for DMs or the dishes as much.
No.
Definitely more Stockton. At best, unfortunately. No one really wears dress shirts.
I sold dress shirts really well in Stockton last time, but we brought a clothes rack.
Yeah.
In Houston, Hagar, Claiborne. Claiborne's Hagar.
Nice.
Hagar, Van Houston.
So JCPenney, Sears.
I'll probably bring a clothes rack. I have this stuff.
Yeah, for sure.
Because then we get like $3 each or two for five, you know?
Well, and they're all nice. They look like they're in good condition, so it's good.
Can't be worse than the last batch. Those ones, rats had run all over them, and they were yellowed. Everything was yellowed. I guess if you get it dry clean, then you leave it in the bag, over time it'll yellow.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I didn't know that.
I did know that.
Pronto Uomo, that's a good brand. Men's Warehouse, but it's a good brand. In Houston.
Alfani. Coffinbauer, whatever. Ashworth. I think that's Sears.
Partner 9.
I think that's Walmart.
What's going on here?
More. Wow, they're all hanging.
Stafford.
Calvin.
This is good stuff. Claiborne. Calvin Klein. Claiborne.
Cool. Double X will sell well at Stockton.
Yeah. Double X, always a good size. Then we have the pants. A little bit more shirts.
All black.
That's good too.
Mm-hmm.
More of the same. Claiborne
like the
and Van Houston.
Brands.
Michael Brandon.
Milani.
Something in Italy. Funny.
Any other goodies?
Let's see.
I don't know. What is it?
Costume? Yeah.
Pirate.
Oh, that's for a little kid, though.
Uh-huh.
There's the pants.
That's
little kid costume
little
pirate.
Little mini pirate costume.
Jeez. Silly. I think that's it for it. Just clothes. More dress clothes, pants and such.
Cool.
Alright, check this out, guys. This is why I had to move the operation indoors. Yeah, it's raining. I knew it was coming. You could just feel it. The table's getting a little wet, but that's okay. The table needs to be washed off anyways. It is supposed to stop raining, in which case I'll move it back out there, I think. But let's go through this one right here. This is not closed. It's kind of interesting. It's a flimsier bag, too. Look at this, guys. Predator action figure. Super cool. Super cool. This is like stuff that would come out of that toy locker that we just finished, kind of. I mean, we're not finished selling the stuff, but we're finished going through the stuff. And NECA, real toys. Yeah, totally the type of stuff we found in there. This is a great auction piece. All right, that's going on our whatnot All right, guys, I just realized I bumped my camera and it wasn't showing anything except for my stomach. Well, in this bag, I've been going through it, not finding too much good stuff, but I did find this. This is pretty cool. Got this HN Next microphone here. Kind of interesting. Well, they call it a handy recorder. And then I've got this right here, which is an accessory pack. Found this first and then found that. So I've got like, I don't know if there's any value on that. Let's see if we can look it up and see if this is valuable at all. If it's a decent quality, it might be something that I actually want to use. Maybe we'll upgrade the mic that we've been using. I don't know. But found that. Happy. Found this. Even more happy. Because it's just so dang cool. Predator action figure. And this is a fugitive predator. Cool. NECA toys. It's made by Real Toys, but it's NECA. Anything NECA seems to be a little bit better quality. Worth a little bit more. It's not big money, but still, it's just so stinking cool and fun. I love finding that stuff. That's the kind of stuff we bought that toy locker recently for and had a blast going through that. Okay, here's Creed. Creed 3. I don't know why they bought both versions, but the Blu-ray we'll put aside, put in our auctions in, this flea market. Oh, what's this? Oh. Whoa. PS Vita. Black Noir. This looks like a PSP. Sealed brand new. Oh, wait a second now. How cool is that? Brand new sealed video game. That is, that's a good find right here. I don't know the value on that. I don't, but it's got to be a few bucks. Ms. Pac-Man. Pocket Player. Portable gaming system. My arcade. This is another sealed brand new piece right here. How cool. Jana loves Ms. Pac-Man. I'm going to see if she wants to play with that first. Die Hard 2. VHS and DVD. Let's see if they have the Blu-ray too. There's some regular stuff coming out now. Die Hard 2, the movie. Alright, here's good. Some more earbuds. Yeah, stereo earbuds. $5 at Ross, not a big deal. We'll put that in an electronics lot. Put a ton of stuff together, you know. What was that? Mortuary, dang it. Sad. Sad stuff. Planner that was never used. So, we'll still sell that. Career in finance. Oh, and then you got the music for Die Hard 2. Why not? Alright, check this out, guys. Sony PlayStation PS Vita. And I put in this right here, PCH2001. That's the number that's on the box right there. And, look at this. $100. This is pre-owned. $100. 102, 122, 102, 137. That one's got some accessories. 97, 125, 212 right here with some accessories and games and such. 177, 92, 85, 90, 193 right here. Wow. I would say that, well, these are all pre-owned. I don't think there's one brand new one. There's a parts only for $33, but look at this, manual and insert only. Box, manual and insert, $23. So, yeah, I got that, obviously. $156, $175. Very good values. I think, well, look at this, $167. Oh, okay, it's got some games. $155. Brand new like this? I think this is $200. I might be off, but it's at least a $150. Should be an easy $150, but I think I'm going to price that at $200 right there. Great, great find. All right, stopped raining here long enough, I think. I hope. We move the operation back outside. Why not? Because we do have some bigger boxes here. I'd rather not carry those all the way into the garage. Okay. Oh, I looked in here at the facility. Looks like mostly toys. That's kind of cool though. San Francisco 49ers. Basketball. That's neat. Okay. Oh, this is heavy. Okay, that I saw that too. Kind of excited about it. Golden State Warriors. Huh. It's flat. Super flat. Okay, look at this stuff. What is this? Sonic the Hedgehog earphones by Sega. That's kind of interesting. Ooh, Cobra Commander. Nice. Alright, there's some kid schoolwork here. Got a couple things competing down there for attention, but this is some garbage in here. Alright. What's this? Spider-Man. Does whatever a spider can. Empty, which means brand new. Needs a pen. Yeah, that's kind of cool. A little journal. Oh, Batman. Hmm, not empty though. Dang it. Let me just tear that page out. It's the first page. It kind of sucks, but... Aye. Maybe I'll cut it out with the razor. Okay. Business letter handbook. All right, guys, let's see what's this. I really wish this thing would turn off. Hmm. All right, that's kind of neat right here. 2012. That's a Hot Wheels. That's a Hot Wheels. Maestro or Maestro Matchbox. Yeah, with the container, it's kind of neat. Just gotta figure out how to ship that because it's a little bit heavy. Oh man, it started to rain again. Come on, give me a break. It's supposed to let up for like an hour. We still have to get to this, guys. Oh my goodness. I mentioned it. I don't know if I mentioned it at the beginning, but this we found in the locker right here. This. And originally I was like, okay, I'm not even that excited about it. It's probably empty. Of course we love opening them. But then I found the jewelry box with jewelry. I found the watch box with watches in it. Now then I hear something shifting around. Now I'm kind of excited about it. We're gonna try to do that. I need to stop raining though. All right, let's see what we got. Got a cheap little camouflage belt. Oh, lots of camouflage stuff. There's an A's lamp. 1982, it's older. Okay, camo, and skulls. These are actually some decent hats made in China. Besides that, the those are great when it's a hot day at the market. People will get $5 all day long on each of those. On a rainy day like this, I doubt we'll get much of anything, but still good find. A couple more charger cables. No, there's just a charger cable. There's an audio cable. Still more electronics is good. What's this? So the LP vinyl. So Finley's Finest, huh? No, Finley's Heroes. Okay, I'll go to D'Enza. Last time we brought a bunch of records out to D'Enza, sold them like crazy for $5 each. They must have been decent. They were in good condition, but they must have been decent records because we sold tons. All right, there's a desktop gargoyle, but he's not home. And this is a Build-A-Bear box. Build-A-Bear also not home. Yeah, this is funny. Golden Girls. They had a bunch of VHSs with the Golden Girls on it. It's funny. Boy, this one's looking like garbage right here. I think this is the kids' room. Broken stuff. Torn up papers. Burger King crowns. Oh, more hats. Oh, 49ers. A little cooler bag. That's cool. Yeah. Giants this time. A little cooler bag. And more camouflage. Heavy duty extreme pack right here. That's clean inside. I don't even think they use that. Little canteen. That's funny. No. That's actually a real knife right here. Real knife with a plastic handle. Jeez. Funny. Going flea market though. That's not a toy. Right here. Genuine leather. Look at that with the little emblem on it. That's actually pretty nice. That we'll put aside. Decent canteen. Okay. The camouflage little pack thing. Well, it says U.S. right here, but it's got his address right there. I don't think this is a real military issue, though. I just don't. But you know what? Camo stuff, still kind of fun. It's a fanny pack. And maybe we put a lot of this in our live auction. Not the knife. The knife's garbage. That's just a toy. A cheap toy. The rest of this is kind of decent. I don't know. Camo lot for anybody? Okay, shows a little boy sleeping in all this dark stuff. A little teddy bear with a sword. That'll give you nightmares if you're a little kid. All right, Altec Lansing in-ear microphones, good, sealed, brand new. All good stuff. I didn't mean to throw it on the ground, but Hot Wheels right here. Garbage. That's cool. Packers. CD holder. Ugh, that's empty. Is authentic, I would take the time to get it back. Yeah, that's kind of neat. There's an Xfinity remote here. It's got a keyboard on the back. This is a little different. Direct TV remote. They got all kinds of different services, apparently. All right, guys. Well, let me go through the rest of this and figure out if there's anything good. There's another alarm clock here. Oh, you are b***ed every day. Heck yes. And the official dictionary of sarcasm. Oh, what's this? Brandon Crawford. Little plaque thing. We're selling these at the market for like, I don't know, $3 to $5 each. Yeah, they kept the Mylar balloons after they ran out of air. That's just so unnecessary. There's a little necklace though. Huh. TX. There's a cheap transformer. Probably knockoff. Vader parking only. That's actually kind of a nice sign. It's metal. I like it. There's a little data card, 8 gigs. And then this right here is metal. Jada Toys. Looks decent. Even though it's thrown in this box right here, it looks like it's in decent condition. I'll put that aside. Okay. 2018 to 2019. That's a little outdated. I don't think anybody's going to be needing that. Good dice right there. Okay, hang on. What's this right here? M. Oh, we got some potential something here. It might be 10K. You know what, guys? I just remembered something. Oh. One of these boxes, I saw a chain. Oh, this is it right here. I saw a chain hanging out the bottom. You see that right there? Hopefully that's coming up on the camera, but I saw that when I was loading this box and I'm like, ooh, I gotta check the corner of this box. Oh yeah. Oh, 14K it says. Holy smokes. I don't believe that, but I can be hopeful. I could be hopeful. That was totally hanging out of the box right there. Good thing too, because I probably wouldn't have checked underneath the flap. Cross. Look at this thing. Progress through Unity, January 1969. Oh, it's all corroded on that side. It's too bad. Candle right there. What is this? I think this might be another stun gun. It's dead, but that is what it is. Zap Light Mini. Okay, we'll take a look at that. Brian Adams. Another little Hot Wheel right here. That's kind of cool. Another cheap transformer. Yeah, we'll put them aside. What's that? Oh, neat. Look at that, you guys. A fidget spinner in the shape of a Nintendo controller. Oh my goodness. So cool. Definitely got to keep checking the bottom of this. Caution, extreme gaming inside. Another metal sign right there. Earring or something? Oh, that's what that cross was. It's an earring. There's the pair. Oh, what's this? Geneva. Yeah, it's a watch. I don't think it's terribly high quality, but the guy did have that nice watch collection. Good little bin. That's cool. $5, light spinner. Jack Skellington. Okay, a little bit more stuff to go through. Hopefully we stay dry here. Okay, Anytime Organizer. Okay, a couple books here. The backpack will sell though. Alright. Another cheap transformer. Cerebral Fix. I have a feeling that's a little bit more death metal. Alright, and that's the Rolodex. That's empty. Put that back in the sell box. We'll sell it. Oh! Okay, $6 on that watch. Music Bullet. Oh, it's a little speaker, but it's like, it's pretty thrash. We'll let it go. Mercedes. Kinsmart, huh? Those are a little bit more beat up right here. They're also very light compared to this one right here. This one's heavier. I don't think we'll sell those. Well, maybe they'll look good if I just wipe them down. They're a little dirty. I'll put some work into it and then I'll decide if I sell them or not. One more Hot Wheels. Just a bunch of junk in here. Music Bullet. Night Eyes Innovations. That's decent. Let me put it with this stuff here. So you guys hear me talking out a lot of, you know, decisions as to where we bring the stuff, where we sell the stuff. It's a big part of this business now. We really do have to maximize all our money. These lockers have gotten so expensive to purchase. You gotta be wise with selling. And you gotta also have some multiple outlets. Can't put all your eggs in one basket anymore. Some guys used to sell just at the flea market. I'm sure some guys still do, but you're not going to get far in this business. You're not going to retire. You're not going to be wealthy unless you get lucky. Like, really lucky. But you shouldn't be relying just on luck. You should be stacking the odds in your favor of doing well. And that's for the phone, little spin pop. I mean, the best way to do that, I think, is to figure out how to sell stuff for max profit, max money. And, you know, we sell flea market, we sell eBay, we sell Whatnot. Most of our stuff goes to Whatnot now. If you guys don't know what Whatnot is, I talk about it in every video, and I'll keep talking about it in every video. I would say that the majority of this stuff we'll probably put into Whatnot. We won't sell it all individually, like probably put those three cars together. You know, we'll lot things up, make nice sets of stuff for people. The electronics will go into electronics lots. Not this, and not this. Whoa. But the rest of the stuff, including like the electronics, like I said, the camouflage, yeah, the more electronics, fragrances, the brand new razors and stuff, this is stuff that we will put into Whatnot in lots. And we'll start the lots at just $1. And that's where we sell most of our stuff these days, guys. That's a good way for us to move it and move it quick and have a lot of fun too. Let's get in here. If you haven't tried it before, go check it out. It's an app for your phone or tablet. You can do it on the computer too, but we'll put links to jump over to our site, and there will be a link to get a $15 spending credit for free the first time you sign up. If you haven't signed up for Whatnot before, make sure you use the link. Use the link, okay? 15 bucks for free, guys. That's on Whatnot for thanking you to try out the platform. They are sure that you're gonna have fun. We're sure you're gonna have fun. That's corroded shut. But you won't know until you go check it out. You won't know. Just take our word for it. But why do that? Why do that? Go check it out. Have some fun. Buy some great stuff if you want. It goes cheap too. We start everything at just $1. Sometimes it sells for a dollar. We prefer when it sells for a little bit more, of course, but we don't really care. I mean, we do care. Don't get me wrong. We want to make some money too. But more importantly, guys, you come have fun. That's really the most important thing to Jan and I. We put on great shows. We try to bring great stuff. We move it as fast as we can so it's fun for you. And, I mean, most people say they do have a great time. So, oh, okay, Vanity Fair here with some Marilyn Monroe stuff. I don't think that's got any value. I think it's going to recycle, but what is this? Canceled, okay. 1971, it was canceled. That's a bond, right? 100 shares for the Washington Post Company. What the heck? That's pretty cool. I don't think I've seen one of those before. Certainly not for this company. The newspaper, right? Washington Post. That is an interesting piece. There's got to be some collectability to that. That's what we'll sell on Whatnot, for sure. What do we got here? Ah. High school diploma. Dang it. Now we're going to have to get this back to them. That's fine. I got most of the units still to clean out. I'll bring all these photos back to them and drop it off at the office. Let them worry about it. What's this? Oh, this is fun. Look at that. Is that a phone? What the heck? That's a phone. There's the mic. That's an oldie. There's an old flip phone too. LG. That's an OG. Mirror. There's some kind of charging cradle for one of these, I bet. Flip floss. It's weird. Come on, jewelry bag. Glasses, bifocals. Some more bifocals here. Those look kind of decent, actually. Quality feels decent. I don't know about glasses. I don't think we've sold prescription glasses on Whatnot before, but I know there's a market for it because there's resellers in that niche. It's an earpiece that plugs into one of the phones. It's funny. Right. It's an overnet bag. Yeah, all right, these we might not get back to the owner. Oh, maybe we will. It's just landscape shots and cards. Now let me get to the next box. Yeah, okay, this is interesting. So at the bottom, there's a picture, I think Italy, because you see the boats right there. I think probably Italy, but I don't know. Probably not nothing, but this. What is this, guys? What is this? Disappointed Barbie. That's a real signature right there, pencil. 1999. Is that a piece of pop art right there? I don't know. That's a little weird, a little different. And a little bit going to the side so I can figure out what to do with that. All right, next bag. Travel gear, it says. Seems like a nicer bag. Definitely nicer condition than the last one. Oh, Okay. More VHS tapes. Yeah, look at this. Allen Iverson, another action figure. Okay, that's good. We sell that. That's going to be a good seller. Good stuff for our auctions. The Whatnot, which we were just talking about. Cassette thing. Earmuffs. Oh, yes. PlayStation controllers. Now we found Nintendo controllers, Sega controllers, and PlayStation controllers. Very good. Very good. Good, 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 good. Worth player bag right here. Huh, it's brand new. We'll put this up. Oh, yes. Look at this. Kiss. Yes. Is this, oh, yeah, McFarlane Toys right there. I was going to say, this is spawn.com. $9.41 brand new. It's probably on sale. That's cool. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. PlayStation 2 remote right there. Brand new. In the box. Brand new. Never open. San Francisco Giants. Nice hat. Cool. Put that aside for the better markets. Yeah, I got some Metallica here. Oh, you hear that? Starting to rain, though. All right, what else we got here? Cassette tapes. Something different. Ooh. What? No way. What? What the heck, you guys? That's... Oh, this... Okay, it's foreign. Foreign money. Canadian, I see, for sure. Maybe some other stuff. Sierra Ski Ranch pin. That's cool. All right. That was in here. It's funny. Okay, what else we got? All right, a bunch of cables. A bunch of don't cares. These guys. Ooh. That's a good one right here. It's metal. That aside. Okay, last thing. We're starting to get a little wet on us here, so gotta get this out. Phil Collins, Robert Palmer, Blondie, Cool and the Gang, Bengals. That's good stuff. I'll bring it to the market. But it's not that death metal stuff that seems to sell fairly well. Top Gun soundtrack. Funny, I had that. I had that back in the day. The Beach Boys, Hard Day's Night, Beatles. Yeah, that's good stuff. It's all right. This one, though. Exodus. What's this one? Cannibal Corpse. That sounds happy. Journey's Greatest Hits. These Metallicas are good too. Alright. Yeah, we'll let the market have it. Yeah, maybe we'll pull it out. Can't make up my mind. Okay, last thing to do. Last thing to get. Last thing to open. You ready? I showed in the last video, stuff shakes around inside. It's exciting. We haven't had a safe with stuff in it in a bit.
A long
The last time we found it was that ring inside of it. The last time we found a safe that had stuff in it.
That's exciting.
Is that? Yeah.
For sure.
This is a big safe, too. I'm gonna, because it's tall.
Yeah. Knock it in there. There you go. You almost make it look easy.
Not open yet. Too early to call that.
It's a wiggle wiggle.
That's just the facade of it.
You're so strong.
Oh, jeez.
You okay?
Keep missing. Dang it.
That looks like it might be.
No.
Is there like cement in there?
Yeah, the cement.
Yeah.
Cement's starting to break up.
That's cool.
Now, could be there's a pin here and here.
Mm-hmm.
I think the pins are here, but I'm not seeing them. Yeah, deeper still.
It's been a long time since you've done this.
Yeah.
Intermission. It's going back into the den.
I don't give myself a heart attack.
Honey, that's really too soon. Too soon for that humor.
Hey, I'll make you go to that one ahead.
That hurts my head. You're strong, honey. There you go.
No.
No?
It's just ripping the lip off.
Not the actual door?
Not yet.
Dang it. Want some goggles?
We don't need no stinking goggles.
I knew you were gonna say that.
Come on.
Use some of that inner wrath you have. I have a silly idea.
What's that?
What if you took the crowbar and put it in, like, going this way? It might rip up, like, the opposite leverage. Like, hook it going in here over this way. I'm trying to give you some counter pressure. Yeah. Come on, little baby.
Last one we had was, it's so easy. Remember?
Yeah, I do. I was like, what? Is that real?
Get my workout today. Just get my heart monitor. See my.
Do you want me to do it?
Because it's going to start raining any second.
I really want there to be money and gold in here.
There's something in here.
Jewels.
This one's not empty.
Diamonds. No, actually, I'd rather have silver and gold. Or money, like cash. Now I'm getting all excited. Try the other side, the other hook, and do that.
This one right here?
Yeah. Do it the way we did it last time with the little hooky.
Hooky?
Hooky.
Slippery.
Yeah. You've been at this for 7 minutes.
Oh boy.
And 48 seconds. Up close. Treasure hunter. Safe breaker. Jack Chisner.
Hold on.
98% auction, 111. That's nothing. Oh yeah, there you go. There you go.
That's it. Okay, we are in, guys. Make sure you get a good view here, because it's coming. Okay. Yeah, there's the pins. So they were on that side, two pins. One of them flew over there. What do we got here? Ooh, we got stuff.
It's actually cool.
Okay.
Gosh, this is
sports memorabilia stuff, I think. Okay, let me get a box.
Woo! Yay! Oh my gosh, you guys. This is so exciting. Usually it's nothing.
Whatever it is good enough that he locked it up, right?
Yeah. I want to see what's in the envelope.
I see baseball cards in the envelope.
Oh!
Ooh. Come on. Oh, I see coins, yeah.
Yay!
I see a coin. Okay.
Baseball coin.
Babe Ruth, some kind of...
commemorative.
Oh, it's a Harris. That's the silver.
Great.
Silver coin. Yay. Oh boy. Wrestling stuff.
Tone changes. You're like, oh, kiss.
Oh, it's a comic book.
Yeah,
no,
let's,
it's a comic book bag.
Let's be careful with all this. This could be
kiss stuff. I found one coin.
It's just exciting there's stuff in there.
Yeah. It's always empty. Okay.
Whoa.
We'll have to clean that up later. Okay. Okay, 40 years. This is not something that should be locked up. That's just a souvenir book, like you get at the games or whatever. And there's just a Kiss magazine.
Great shape, though.
Yeah. Another one, Psycho Circus Tour magazine.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think those are any value, though.
Really?
I don't think so. Okay, now this.
Kiss comic book.
Marvel Super Special Kiss. That looks like it's in okay condition.
But look, $40 when they bought it.
It's pretty dang cool.
I mean, that's that might be 70, something.
Oh, it says 78 right there.
Mm-hmm.
Since after 78 was released.
Okay.
Another one.
Nice.
Yeah, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That's a little bit better, right?
Mm-hmm.
A Nightmare on Elm Street. Freddy Krueger.
Number two.
And this is...
Marvel.
I don't see the year, but that's... the movie came out in the 80s, right? Mid-80s, like 85 or something.
Okay. We would not expect this.
No. Hmm. That's kind of interesting. And then here's Terminator 2, Judgment Day comic
book.
Very
good.
Marvel. Yeah, I don't know about values on these. We'll look them up. Terminator 3.
He's so our age.
That's cool. Kiss.
Yeah.
1977 right here. It's some kind of a...
picture.
It is, huh? It's just a... that's art right here. Mm-hmm. I think it's the album
Maybe
cover.
From like a concert.
That is the album cover. Because I found the album. Mm. All right, there's some wrestling stuff like cards and stuff. We'll open that in a sec.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what else we got here. Undertaker.
Mm-hmm.
Toss baseball card. Price guide, right? But that's...
mm-hmm.
That's nothing. That's... 1 ounce of silver right here.
Yeah, baby.
It's $30 to $40, but because it's Harris, Babe Ruth, it might be worth more.
Yeah. Oh, these ones are before. Those are kind of worth a little bit of money.
Are they?
These are the mother's ones. Yeah, we have those. Yeah, uncut.
Huh, okay.
I remember those.
I don't remember that being worth something, but okay. All right. Come on.
Could this be the baseball card we've been looking to find all of these days?
Wait. Joe Montana sign right there. You might switch to one. Yeah. Okay. That's very interesting, right?
Mm-hmm.
NFC All Pro.
That's fabulous.
Yeah, that's good. What's this? Mark McGuire, first base.
Oh, it's his rookie, I think.
You think?
I think so.
No. It's got 3 years of...
no, it might be his college one. USA.
Oh, statistics at USC.
Yeah, it's his college card. That is worth more, I think.
Okay.
Okay.
Q
Ken Griffey Jr.
Ken's got some good cards.
Ken Griffey Jr.
That's his rookie.
This.
Mm-hmm. We've had that before.
Ken Griffey Jr.
That's in good condition.
Ken Griffey Jr. I got some concrete on my hands.
Yeah, maybe don't touch him.
Okay. Well, this is weird because there's like a fantasy thing there. And then Travis Jervey. Hmm. Okay.
Barry
Bonds, a little pack of cards here. Giants.
Mm-hmm.
87, though.
Could be
87. Will Clark on top there. Mark McGwire.
They look very clean. I was hoping to find some older ones.
Will Clark.
Mm-hmm. He liked the Giants?
Yeah. 87 Giants is nothing. I don't think 87. These are not the right years, Giz. Wedding Chapel. Little San Francisco Giants pin right here. Oh,
that's their signature.
Joe Montana.
Joe Montana.
To Jason, best wishes, Joe Montana from Kilpatrick's Bakeries.
Oh, I love it. Maybe he worked there and he came in.
There's something.
Oh, that's the engagement ring receipt, I'm guessing.
Oh, boy. Joel Youngblood. Will Clark, I think. Will Clark.
He liked his Wills.
Will Clark. Well, the Giants says probably Will Clark is number one. That is it.
Okay.
I think the best so far is Joe Montana. But I don't know my cards, right?
You don't.
I'm not that interested. I like the comics better. Let's see what's in here, okay? This is, he's really into Undertaker.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he liked his wrestling, but especially Undertaker. Everything's Undertaker. Undertaker. Oh, there's a picture of Undertaker. I think that's him too. Our guy.
That's him?
When he's young. Yeah. Undertaker. There might be some value in those cards.
Yeah.
And a couple little clippy things.
I think it's funny what people think is worthy to put in a safe.
Yeah.
I find it very interesting.
I don't think any of this is big money. The Joe Montana thing might be $100. I don't know.
It's exciting though.
Yeah, it's fun. Hey, we found a full safe. It was pretty full.
It was fun.
Yeah. I think the safe is worth as much as all the stuff in it. I don't know, though. I don't know. We're going to look this stuff up. We'll let you guys know if there's a good value here.